Welcome back to Let's Play Obduction. I'm the RPG chick. Going back to Moray. Don't worry, just passing through. And only passing some of the way through, actually. I'm not sure if this is the best way to go, or the only way that you should go. Hello, Farley. Oops. Hello, Farley. Don't panic. Now that's the end. Alright, we loop around, so we're gonna go this way. That's a dead end. I'm not sure which way to go, that's the problem. Oh, I just came from here, duh. I meant this. We want to find our way back to all those pods. Seeming familiar yet? I just want to look. Nothing to say now, don't you? Because you're dead. About time. Thought it wasn't coming. This is the way I figured out. I'm hoping I don't have to take a certain one through. I can just take any of them. I'll take this one. Because this is the one that had the panel, I think. Not that we need the panel, but it's worked before, so that's my only rationale. We want to come out that door. Now that I've extended the bridge to the other side of the river, we can continue down that way. That and that reactor, or whatever it is, in the middle of that pond is the only place I can think of that we haven't been to yet. I think this is the way. No. Wait. Loading. This must be the way. Yeah, yeah. It is the way out. I remember this long loading screen. It's loading the outside. Okay. So now, if you'll let me out, we're on the other side, and we can go on this side. Sweet! And I've been wondering about this side since, I don't know, episode 3, 4? Thrilled to finally get across here. Ridiculous, too, there's a rowboat. We can't even use it. And this is that painting we saw. Cool. Very cool. And this... Oh, we broke another one. We can't avoid that, though. The track is up there. I think it's up there, actually. Can't see it from here. I wonder if I go back further, we can see the a little bit of the track. Not really. I guess it comes out there. There's the way down to the lower part of the junkyard. So we took this. We took the rail car up there, which is we had to take that tunnel through. Just recapping, take that tunnel into the sphere, the force field, or whatever the hell, to teleport through up here with the rail car, the mine car, and shine the blue beam down here. This was all rocks. So that's now revealed. And I did that not knowing what the hell when we could get over to that side. Oh, butterflies. But it's paying off now, baby. Alright, so there's really nothing else over here, but we go in this way. And another thing we can't listen to, which makes me sad. Oh! Okay. There's a seed swap thing. More stuff? Oh, paper? Please read thoroughly. We must have every detail in place. Our lives and our species depend on this being executed perfectly. The locations and times of this document are based on the information leaked by Ruko and Chavar. Those are the Mofang in the pods that we saw a couple episodes ago. So I think I've read this. Of course I've read this. We swapped this out. Right? I've seen this? Or it's a duplicate? I remember the chair. Isn't this the same note? So let me, recap. Information we received from Ruko and Chavar. So they were not with the rest of the Mofang. They helped us, apparently. CW on Earth, Char, Aprar, and Orbar, Moray to the, oh, that's where they are. Anai, one Polyarch on Kaptar. Oh, no, right, that the Arai are on Kaptar. The Valain are from Moray. So they began chambering. Farley verifies manifest all souls chambered. Remainers in place with hands on swap trigger. Okay. So they all have a swap trigger, including CW. I'm kind of wondering if CW would have any of the lines now that we've accomplished this, but it's going to be hellishly hard to get back there. We can't activate that gate and that whatever that we walk on. Sorry. I can't activate it from that side, so we'd have to go all the way over. And there's no force field to bounce off of over here to just get back and forth. Yeah. So, well, I'd like to see if he'd say anything else. Just didn't think of it. Ruko and Chavar arrive, chambered by Char. Char on guard of chamber. Char. Oh. Char must have been that one who was hurt. He was the one who was hurt. The only person we've found, you know, that we could actually theoretically, you know, touch, but of course we can't do that. Everyone else is through a porthole or a vid screen. Trigger locations as prescribed. All locations have small error allowance. Moray has the largest margin of error potential. Be alert. Trigger re-swap immediately after swap. Any delay increases the risk of detonation in a home sphere and the risk of a remainder being disabled in Mofang. Communication Farley. I'll ensure that all remainers, or in the case of Captor, the remaining Polyarch, receive and understand this document. So this might be a duplicate, or this might be from the seed we found in Moraine. This is red. We're going to Soria, aren't we? Soria, as you, in case you guys forgot, is the home of the Mofang. Maybe I should have copied my game again. I don't know if we can die again. I have no idea what we're in for here. I am going to copy the game. That's how you make a copy. If we die, I think that's it. Credits roll and it saves like that, so. Could possibly die here. I don't know. Oh! A little sphere, okay. Alright, we're gonna look around, obviously. I wonder if we have to find a blue device, if we can disrupt these. They might not be illusory, they might just be, you know. Just lights. Alright. We have one way. And spooky music. It's like a cool off like lava flow or something. Or kind of reminds me of, what do you call it? Like pottery, right? When you're mixing it with your hands kind of thing and making pottery. That glistening brown look. Feels like almost slippery to walk around in here. Almost. Not quite. Okay, this just goes all the way around. No other passages? Okay. We have that way. And we have this way. I keep getting close to this stuff, just curious if it would kill me. What about that other path? Oh. Well, this is a dead end. So we have to take the other path. Dun dun dun. Love the music. I do love the music. This way. If this is a dead end, then I don't know what to have to do. Oh, this is a tree? Cool. Tree. Anything else around here? overlooking that crater there, sort of, whatever that is. Down to the tree. Looks like we're going down to the tree. Nothing else to see. No. Just directly to this. Alright. Wish me luck. Gotta be something. I thought I heard a voice. That's it. I don't have to go through anything in here. I just turn the water on. Captar. Moray. What do you call it? Welcome to Hunrath here. What are they expect to be doing this so soon? What do we do now? This goes back to, what do you call it? Moray. I'm guessing we have to go back there. This goes to Captar. I hope I don't have to go through Captar again, because I closed the way to the hive. I can't get out. I'd have to take another way. I closed that gear. Back to Hunrath? If nothing else, talk to CW if nothing comes up. Okay. Maybe when we come out of the tree, something will just happen, I have a feeling. Loading, loading. Let me go. Thank you. Oh. Happy tree? Okay. What now what? Oh wait, you know, I want to go to the top. The names... I didn't realize that at the time, but the names of all those places are up there with you know, dials, indicators. Now they're all on. Hunrath, Moray, Mofang, and Captar. Mofang is climbing as we speak. Still nothing to do around here. This does something with that. Gotta be. Maybe when this is... could be. Maybe when this is all the way to 100? It's still charging up? I don't know about this, I can't tell. Obviously, Hunrath. Or maybe Hunrath. Maybe we don't have all the power yet. It needs to go all the way there, which we will be able to achieve by doing that. But maybe Mofang has to be up first, or maybe CW has to tell us something to do. So I'm going to go talk to CW, rather than wait up there. Because even if that's the truth, I just wait till it reach 100 on Mofang, which... It should say Soria. That's the name of their world. Why does it say Mofang instead? Oh. Wait. I need to bounce off. I can't get down that way. Because I turned the thing the other way. The gate. The water gate thing. So I need to bounce off the sphere so I can get back. In order to get back to CW. In town. Oh wait, I can't even go this way. Well, we can still get down from this way. But we can't get back across from here. This is just... This thing just lifts this up, and that's not going to do us any good. From here... I'm just thinking. I have some ways blocked off. I just found a sphere to bounce off of. I get back to town. So... Wait, I can go through the community center. Because there's really nothing that bounces you off near town. See? We still have to find out how to come out there. Maybe CW will let us in. Maybe we can get through there. There's another tunnel. There's obviously another tunnel we haven't seen yet. Unless I have to swap something else out. Unfortunately, I have to walk all this way. There's probably a quicker way that I just have not realized. But we'll be there. In a few seconds. Still wonder what those other messages said. With the blowed up things. We blew up that one. Just to see what would happen. Use in here. Yo! CW! You better be proud of me this time. Not all grouchy like you were. You better not be another imitation. The bleeder.
Gotta stop it. It's draining the whole system. It keeps things under control. Holding us back.
Is that that thing over there? Reactor? Keeps it under control. Please tell me how to get there.
You track that bleeder.
How?
If everything's connected, we'll be...
Tell me how to get there. No! What are you doing back there anyway? The doorbell doesn't even ring anymore. Ding dong, mofo. Guy thinks I'm like been here years and I know my way around this place expertly. I mean, granted, I've learned a lot, but... Sheesh. I can get back to the other side from here. I just need to switch the gate. That's fine. Oh, wait. Can I? The whole contraption's on that side. Let me see. Damn it! Alright. Trying to piss me off, CW, aren't you? Farley's gonna hear about this when she wakes up. She might be awake now. Everyone might be woken up and thawed out. I don't know under whose authority, but... Nope, we have to go all the way. Unless I want to go between worlds. Yes, I'll skip that. Alright. To the community center. Let me just try now that everything's, like, maybe something's been swapped around so I can get there. We want to go... I'm guessing this is the bleeder. There's some photo about that, isn't it? That's the volume projector. I don't want to mess with those panels anymore. I don't know which one it is, or who knows, I might have forgotten to take a picture of it. Mofang Disabler, right? The Bleeder Project... Okay, this is topical. At your behest, here is the information pertaining to the Bleeder, its history, and some of the engineering behind it. The Bleeder Project was designed and built at the request of Mayor Sims to collect and dissipate the ever-increasing power in the entire ecosystem. Mayor Sims was reluctant to allow the system to come to fruition, as he and others had become suspicious of Mayor Farley's death. He believed that without knowing more precisely what could happen to the cell wall at fruition, it was ill-advised to allow it to possibly open, thus allowing might be inside in, and what might be inside out. The system has the capacity to throttle all four connected worlds. The idea, as you are well aware, is to suppress the ecosystem's power and thus inhibit full maturity of the trees. Oh, so we want to make the trees fully mature then. It was postulated and since became apparent that this suppression will keep whatever unknown maturity process from happening and grant us direct control over tree fruition. This is it. That's the picture of it. The rate of dissipation is sensed and regulated automatically. The power is collected through Valaine-engineered extruded cables that attach directly to the dome membrane. Okay. Valaine cables. When the maximum power level is exceeded, the dissipation phase is triggered, creating an electrical charge followed by a discharge into the water. That's that sound we sometimes hear. Like, vroom. Through electrolysis, an amount of hydrogen and oxygen is generated. We capture some of these elements for our own use, but the great majority is released into our atmosphere. This gassing might be a cause for concern were it not for the ecosystem's ability to filter and maintain our atmosphere at near ideal levels. Excess hydrogen and oxygen content and pressure generated by the process is rebalanced quickly by the membrane, and as you know, we discourage swimming when the bleeder is operational. Regards, CW. Well, he tells me all about this thing. That looks like another thing, like, by the gate. Grating, right? By the river that we walked across. We've never found our way over there. Never. That's the way there. I'm just checking to make sure there's no way open now. That, like, CW wasn't open away, or us swapping back and forth. And let me just peek through here. No. Well, put this back over here. That's the one thing we haven't figured out. And oh, yes, I've been through all these. All these areas. In my wanderings, my explorations. Unless I go through another spot. That puts me there. What if I go all the way this side? That's a dissipation. Are we headed towards it? No. We're still over here. We need to find a way to bounce off or take a seed or something. Gotta love this guy. Whenever he comes out of that thing, I'm gonna choke him to death. Tell us to do all this stuff, and we have no idea how to do it. I want to get to the other side. I basically want to be just over here, somehow. Through there, maybe? But we've gone through there, and that hasn't... brought us anywhere, has it? No, we've been over here. Haven't we? No, now we're heading all the way away from it. Oh, there's one of those things. There's one of the Arai over there. Can you grab me and just fly me over there? That'd be great. So close yet so far. Look, it's stuck. Keep going, baby. All right. Yeah, I have no idea how to get there. So, oh, I want to cross over there, but we can't. Back over to the tower and check out those levels. Hope you guys aren't bored. Stiff, it takes me forever just to accomplish anything. All I have to do now is get rid of the bleeder, and I have to figure out how to do that. At least I know how to get up here. Oops. If there's anything we can do. $100. Now this would be lit, but the bulb is broken for some reason. Not sure what that's about. I'm guessing we're at 100? I'm not sure. Oh, you know what? We're not, because of the bleeder. Keeps it from being 100. So everything else is set to 100 if we... What? What about these TVs? Man, do something. Try this again. I'm trying random stuff, maybe I have to keep doing it. Oh. But we've seen that happen before, right? Well, I haven't seen it lit up the lake before, but that's because we haven't had this vantage point, right? How do I turn it off? Obviously, I have to come out that section, which I can't really see. There's a walkway. Can't really see it from here because it's on the other side of this. This is the way we keep coming out looking at it. There's a way in or through. I don't know. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. I gotta sign off here because I gotta figure out what the hell to do. How to get over there. What this does. And there's no other buttons or anything to mess with. Believe me, I'd love to mess with stuff. These are lights, not buttons. So weird we have this thing. It's a camera, but it looks like a rearview mirror. And this TV. These lines are plugged in somewhere. What's this? That looks like a button, doesn't it? This calls the elevator. I hear it. It's releasing the charge. We can't get to 100 with that thing on. I could just jump to my doom. But instead, I'll call it an episode. And thanks for so much for watching, guys. And hopefully next time, we figure out what the hell to do. Until then, always seek adventure.